Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Richard Ridio, back again at the Arlyn Pillay Art Gallery, recording the Arlyn Pillay podcast. To my left, we're going to skip you, Omar, real quick.
That's fine. You just introduced me.
I know, but yeah, that's... And we're going to go to the man, the myth, the legend, Arlyn Pillay. Chase is down there. Unfortunately, Chase is sick, so he'll be back next week. And Omar, I forgot how to say your last name. You have a really cool last name.
You can just stick with Omar.
I could say it.
Go for it.
Oseguerda.
Oh, very cool.
That's it? Damn it. Oh, man. I thought I had this.
You put an R in there.
Oseguerda.
There you go.
Okay, I like that.
Oh, okay, how do you say it?
Sorry.
Oseguerda.
Oh, okay, never mind. I'm not going to say that.
That's why I said, let's stick with Omar.
Anyways, so our social media links will be popping up and after our names and stuff, so go ahead and check out all that cool stuff. And, yeah, how you guys doing? It's been like a whole week since we recorded with me and Arlyn. Omar, how are you doing? How's your new year?
It's fine so far.
Fine.
Better than last year.
You said that you had a very uneventful day today so far. We had a pre-talk before we start our pre-discussion before we started recording.
Yeah.
Would you like to know more?
Yes. Fill in the details.
So, kind of, yes.
Okay. So, you know, wake up, breakfast.
What'd you have for breakfast?
I had...
wake up. Have a little breakfast. Sorry.
You're a vegan?
I thought of the System of the Down song.
I was vegan for 2 years.
You're vegan? No way.
And you know this.
The vegan police are outside the door.
I don't care about that. That's the society. So, yeah, it's just plant-based for now, health reasons. But I had vegan pancakes and vegan
Do they
eggs.
Taste like crap? Because it sounds like
no.
It tastes like... Cause it was
I
like,
didn't say they did. So maybe I'll bring some next
so
time.
Vegan pancakes, like there's no milk or...
No.
So there's no milk.
No. Is that
there's
what
no
you
eggs?
Look for in your pancakes? Where's the milk?
Don't they put milk in pancakes, right? When they make it, right?
Is it?
Don't they?
No.
Unless you have like the...
I don't know. I've never made pancakes.
Oh,
so.
Yeah.
Because I saw white stuff and I was like, oh, that's milk, right? I'm sorry.
That's a flour.
Okay, that's a flour.
Yeah.
All right.
We're on the same page, right?
This is making it already awkward for Omar. This is awesome.
No, this is fun.
Okay, so what'd you have for what'd you do midday?
Midday, I went to the library for like an hour.
Oh, so you like reading?
No.
Like, why did you go to the library?
I just look at people.
No, that's not weird.
I just hit the library once in a while just to. They have a huge graphic novel section.
Oh, okay. Ooh. So you did read. Okay. So what
yeah,
do you would you would you what do
what
you like
did
reading?
I read. I was reading Miracle Man.
Oh,
yeah.
Never heard of that. Who's the author?
Oh, yeah, Miracle Man.
It's
you don't know the author. It's okay.
It was Neil Gaiman.
Neil Gaiman? What has he written?
Sandman?
Coraline?
Come on.
Okay, no, I didn't know this guy.
Cool
really?
Stuff.
Okay, cool. Wait, I'm going to check this guy out now.
Miracle Man?
Miracle Man. Okay.
Yeah. What about that new movie that came out with the like kids with powers, like from a school? Was that directed by Tim Burton, maybe written by Neil?
What the heck? Dude, that sounds like an acid trip.
Yeah, it's like
yeah.
The school of something kids or
school
the
of
peculiar
school
or the peculiar I don't know. I forget the title, but we have the book over here. Anyway.
What?
But
I don't see that.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's like Omar's like, I'm down to read that.
Yeah, so Miracle Man, I only got like halfway through. Very strange.
Yeah.
So you like comic books then too, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You love comic books, sounds like.
I've kind of stepped away from
I gotta turn my phone off. Sorry. Go ahead. Keep going.
Wow, man.
Yeah.
I
how unprofessional.
Sorry.
Let me turn off my phone too.
I actually haven't followed a lot of comics over the last like 7-8 months.
Okay.
I kinda just fell out of it. Other stuff kind of came in the way.
Just reading other stuff.
Yeah, just doing other stuff.
Other entertainment.
Watching other stuff. Other entertainment. I kind of have to get back. You know.
Well, you don't have to.
Well,
it's just like when
I
you
have
ever.
To. Because
okay.
I have a need to
okay.
read sometimes.
The need to read. The need for speed.
Okay.
That's it. That's
I learned
a good,
lot
that,
of new
that
vocabulary
off.
From comics, surprisingly. That's what it is.
So
or like I get introduced to words that I've totally forgot didn't exist.
Like what?
Like procrastinate.
Oh,
I was like,
you didn't know that one?
I knew, but I don't use it in my. I like for me, I don't use like those kind of like I don't not big words. I'm saying
that's
I don't
a big
like,
word
for me. That's a big word because like I'm like who says procrastinate in like a conversation? Yeah. Like oh, I was procrastinating. It's like I would just tangenting on and being really annoying. That's like my word
being
for
lazy.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah, okay, gotcha. Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
So yeah, I did that for an hour.
And then sterile like people like.
No, I went back home and then geared up to hit the gym for an hour and a half.
Is that New Year's resolution?
No, I've been. I've
I'm
been
running tomorrow morning, starting tomorrow.
No, I've been going. There was a gym that opened up like 5 minutes from my house.
So you're doing like legs? What are you doing? Running? You're doing upper body?
It depends on the day.
Okay.
You know.
It's good to mix it up, by the way.
Yeah. I totally agree.
So did you like, have you done sports or anything like that?
I used to play soccer when I was much smaller.
Didn't do anything in high school then?
No. High school was all it was all about music.
Okay.
Nice.
So you're a musician?
I used to be. I haven't played in a while.
Don't.
What'd you play?
Like, I used
I play, like, but not like in a band.
Oh, okay.
What did you play? Bass? Guitar?
Yeah, bass.
What?
I taught myself everything.
Dude, that's awesome.
I can play for you, Arlyn.
I'm just kidding.
We play together.
So, yeah, I taught myself bass. I taught myself guitar. I played drums at fifth grade.
So you self-taught yourself. That's pretty cool.
So
I wish I could do that. I'm just not.
Not disciplined?
Well, I mean,
you're
I'm
lazy?
Disciplined in other
procrastinator? Sorry, we're teaming up against Richard.
I procrastinate when I was playing guitar. I think I had a conversation with Arlyn about trying to learn to play the guitar. I just like
it's never too late, man.
Yeah, I know it's still like never too late. I have a guitar like staring at me in my room, but it's just there for decoration. Yeah, but what was I saying? No, I'm more disciplined in like because I played football and that's where I'm more disciplined. Like I know the ins and outs when I see family members talk like the Raiders this past year. Really good. You probably don't follow football, but they had a really good season. And, like, it was just really funny to watch these guys try to talk about how good the Raiders are or why they're so good.
Sure.
But, like, they had no, like, evidence or, like, what was going on internally. Like, because I know the ins and outs of, like, why things happen.
Sure.
And it's really, it's a complicated thing.
Were
okay?
they just trying to, like, sound, like, very smart?
Fast? No, actually, no. Like, no technique and everything and why something is like that. Like, why a bone breaks like that because of the guy.
Sure. Okay.
So you, but you know what I mean.
Yeah. I totally know. What
yeah. You know what I mean.
Yeah.
Technique.
Yeah. Everything.
I don't know what you mean. Doesn't matter.
It's okay. Let's move on.
Oh, Chase is still here, by the way, guys.
Chase is going to comment on something.
He's the ghost of the gallery tonight.
Chase said he's learning so much about Omar.
Yeah, and we like.
I'm going to be repeating Chase.
You guys like worked together for a while, right?
Yeah.
He just never talks. Like, Chase started talking. He's like, Chase, go in the corner over there.
I don't want to talk right now.
Well, I mean, I've been here and like I've worked for a little bit. And like, I remember there was times with me and Chase where like literally we would do something and we'd just be in silence. It's not like we didn't have anything to talk to. We would talk about a lot of stuff. But like, it was just like a weird, not weird, but like it was like a natural silence of like working.
Right.
So yeah. I've done that.
It was
You're pretty good at talking. When someone comes in, you're like you always like to show them. That's a good icebreaker for you.
Yeah.
It's a very good icebreaker. But there's a lot of people that are dicks, Chase, though, out there. They just like they'll talk to you and like okay, and then they just walk away. I'm like.
I'm kind of imagining a scene where it's like a couple fighting. And then, like, then it's really quiet and awkward, and in the background's playing that song, "I'm sorry, so sorry."
I don't know. I'm not from the '80s. Is that an '80s song?
You don't remember that? You don't remember that? That was like it was from a movie scene, but it was really good.
Maybe that's why I haven't seen.
I could just imagine. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I haven't seen. I still haven't seen Back to the Future.
What the? Dude, I think I'm younger than you. What the heck is going on here, man?
I have other things going on.
Yeah, but that's called your childhood right there.
No, I had my childhood was fine, all right?
No, dude. If you didn't watch...
Just because it didn't include Back to the
Future.
Dude,
how do you not watch Back to the Future?
I just never got around to it.
Do you have siblings?
Yeah.
Oh, your siblings don't love you then. That's
hey,
what
that
it
should
is.
Be the
I
first
no
movie
idea.
For movie night.
Never ask them.
If we have a movie night at the gallery, the first movie should be Back to the Future.
And Omar is going to be
Omar,
present, hopefully.
Hosted by Omar.
Hosted by me.
Hosted by
who
Omar.
Knows who's nothing
never
I just know they go back to the future. That's it.
Maybe they don't. Maybe
sometimes
it's like
they go
a,
to the,
you know,
sometimes they go
switcheroo.
To the future. Okay? If you didn't know that. Cause
well,
never
I've
watched
never
the
watched the movie.
Exactly.
So how am I supposed to know?
Have you watched what's it called? Indiana Jones?
Yeah.
Star Wars?
Yep.
These are just nerdy titles. Ghostbusters?
Yep.
Revenge of the Nerds?
Well, not the latest one.
Oh, no, don't watch that. I heard it was really bad.
So
I've been
did.
Avoiding that one.
It depends on who you talk to.
Yeah. What about new movies that you really enjoyed?
Arrival?
Oh, okay. Ooh, I haven't
I
seen that yet.
Yeah,
I've been.
Don't give
it
away. I
side.
Heard there's a it's thing good. At the end. It's good,
you
right?
You might like it.
I'll watch it.
Oh, Chase is raising a hand. What's going on, Chase?
I've never seen a SpongeBob movie.
So Chase just asked if he's seen the SpongeBob movie, by the way. Sorry.
Is that the one we watched with the what's his name at the end?
Are you talking about the live action?
We won't speak of.
There's a live action SpongeBob movie.
Yeah, it's like CG sponge. With like people and stuff. It's really weird.
No, it's the old one.
The old one, okay. Yeah. Oh, that one. I love that one.
I'm not. I have.
We
not.
Were kids for that. That's why.
Yeah. Still good. Arlyn likes it.
Yeah.
No, I like.
Maybe Arlyn said that just so you can like
not watch the movie.
Please you.
To can please you.
I think that's wrong choice of words. Yeah.
I'm just kidding, Chase.
Hey, so let's talk about this guy and his amazing abilities.
Yes.
Yes.
Do you want to go grab some prints, by the way, too? I'm just saying. Like, please, Chase.
So we could show Omar's awesome
some of your prints.
Awesome works.
Okay.
Oh,
sure.
the Pokemon one and
yeah, I heard the I forgot her name. Sorry, what was her name?
Whose name?
Oh, Bella? Sheila.
Serena.
No.
Serena.
Yeah.
She was talking about like, how good that was and that you sold it. And she was like congratulating
yeah,
you.
Yeah, the Pokemon Hunter. The Hunterin.
Hunterin.
Mm. Hunterin.
Yeah.
When I first saw it, I was like, oh, he spelled haunting wrong.
No.
And then I was like, Chase, like, no, don't change it. It's the Pokemon.
Almost changed.
No, I was like,
he's like, this guy's an idiot. Why did he spell this wrong? Chase
was
like, no.
Because I don't know much about Pokemon. And I was
fair
like,
enough.
Yeah, I was like, okay.
He knows nothing.
He knows nothing.
Just nothing.
That's why I made.
I will hold the art, and then you can you
talk
can
about it.
Talk about it. I will probably have like a bigger.
Oh
image.
Yeah, yeah, because I did the cover for the pet.
Oh man, my friends love that.
Which one? The Pikachu pancake one. See, there you go. I know nothing about Pikachu. My talent.
Didn't say your Pikachu was bad.
No, I'm just saying the fact that I knew nothing about it enabled me to break the mold and create this derpy looking
great.
Yeah, so
I still have that flyer.
Thanks, man. It's a collector's now. Yeah, anyway, enough about me. Omar,
so how did you make this
with a pen?
Okay. Yeah. Obviously
Bristol, if you want to get technical.
Well, no, I feel like you should make like comic book covers already, like this stuff, like it's like different.
Well, he is working on his own comic.
Well, that remains to be seen.
Yes.
I may be putting that on hold indefinitely.
Top secret G4 classified.
It's
well, not no longer because it's on the podcast.
It's
so.
Sure. but I mean, some there's like what, like 12 pages on it floating around the internet. So.
Oh, okay. All right.
But
if you need a writer, I'm here.
Yes.
Wait, I thought you're the writer.
I am the writer, but I'm not a very good writer.
Okay. Okay.
I found.
Okay.
Oh, at least I think.
Okay.
I need to work on my writing skills. But yeah, I have a comic out, but I'm just putting that on indefinite hiatus and just kind of want to do like a short story kind of series.
Okay. Nice.
I'm not very good with huge arcs.
Okay.
So
there's nothing wrong with that.
Did you say
you got to start. I mean,
like for the story arc. Oh, storyline.
Yeah.
Because some people don't know arc, like McDonald's
yeah,
arcs.
Yeah.
What are you talking
like
about?
Like a
you
huge
know? Like arc, like in a story
yeah,
plot.
Like
I got what he said.
DC and Marvel do.
Yeah.
There's a huge like.
Yeah, but sometimes those are like unrewarding at the end.
Right.
So you want to do it the right way. I'm saying
exactly.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Kind of like Sandman. I want my own Sandman.
Okay.
You're not familiar with Sandman.
I need to read that. Okay.
You need
I'm
to read
sorry.
That came out in the 90s.
Borrow Sandman.
Okay. I will let you borrow Saga because I think you need to read Saga.
I've read Saga.
Okay. What about Paper Girl? Paper Girl?
Paper Girl? I have not.
It's same writer, but it's way cooler. It's girls from the 80s that did, they're like paper boys.
Okay.
And they go time travel and shit.
Oh. Okay.
It's really weird.
Okay.
I think you'll like it. If you like Saga, you're definitely going to like this.
Okay. Fair enough. All right, I think we got
agreed.
A trade going on.
Agreed.
It's okay. On camera, though. So.
No, I have every issue. I think they just restarted. They're going to restart. They're only on issue 7, but they're going to start it back up, I think, next month.
Okay, cool.
So. Nice. But yeah, Brian K. Vaughn. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Love the guy.
I'll
great writer.
This one so. For now. I'll somehow get a, you need, or either, you. I think Arlyn will have one, or I'll look on the internet, or send me something
sure.
So I can put this up. At,
yeah,
the video.
I have those. Somewhere on my computer, so
nice.
I can always.
I like how yeah, it feels like a comic book like. Kind
yeah,
of
very.
Like
a lot of my work is like very illustration, comic kind of based. That's kind of where I was going on.
I really envy you, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
From a distance, I just don't like to show it.
You could shake his hand. Oh, you did.
Yeah.
All right.
So
all
he's
right.
Already there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like I said, I comic books, just kind of what I grew up. I was a huge Spawn fan when it first
ooh,
came out.
Right okay. On, man. Right
so
here. Pound
McFarlane.
It.
Oh, yeah.
I just saw him at a video game convention.
Okay.
So he's pretty cool. He's really nice.
Good to know.
Yeah.
I heard they're going to remake
it. You haven't met him in person?
I have not met
what?
Him.
What?
I haven't been around.
Oh, man, dude.
If you get a chance to go to Arizona Comic Con, because he lives up there, you'll probably bump into him.
And they have a bunch of McFarlane's shops out there. So if like you're into action figures, for sure. Like they're like... They have everything McFarlane, so it's like going into like a Toys R Us.
Sure.
But like with McFarlane. Spawn, okay. Halo, I think they do Gears of War stuff now.
Gotcha.
A bunch of like it's really, and then they have art as well. They have like prints and whatnot.
Cool. Okay. I'm in Arizona.
No, I'm serious. It's for like for someone that likes McFarlane stuff. That's a really cool place to go.
Yeah,
even just to go even check it out.
Sure,
like,
sure.
There's a lot of cool stuff.
Yeah. So huge Spawn fan back when it was huge.
In the 90s. Back when I was
huge. Batman as well, like anybody.
Everyone's Batman.
Spider-Man?
Spider-Man. I didn't get into Spider-Man until like the last few years, actually.
Did you feel like the creation of Spawn is kind of like him taking Batman and Spider-Man and putting them together? Because like Spawn is kind of like Spider-Man, but with Batman's darkness.
Okay, there's like...
Maybe.
Let me stop you.
Am I the only one drawing that kind of...
Maybe.
Because he did do Spider-Man. Yeah.
There's a cover that Spawn kind of parodies. A Spider-Man cover.
Right.
So I totally understand.
Oh, okay.
But like...
You don't feel like that's where
I'm not sure
got the idea from.
Maybe Venom.
Okay. Oh, right. Okay, makes sense.
Yeah.
And he did do...
I don't know if he did Venom.
He did the black Spider-Man's black costume. That's
okay.
Yeah,
the
before
alien
the alien.
Saga.
Yeah, so then that
okay,
makes
fair
more
enough.
Sense,
I don't know.
Dude.
But I'm like, I would be totally fine because I feel like with comic book characters, there needs to be new characters, regardless. Like I'm okay with someone like having like, oh, he stole this from someone. I was like, yeah, but he made it better.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like I'm okay with like video game ideas like that. Like very much people will do compare like, oh, this is exactly like this. Yeah, but they made it better than the original one.
Right.
So
you're okay with that. Basically.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
I totally agree.
Yeah.
If they can make it better.
Yeah.
Good on them.
And then I don't like the people who are like, oh, you stole my idea. Oh, you ripped me off. I'm
well,
like, no.
If it's a straight ripoff.
Oh,
I
a straight ripoff. But no, I'm like an influence. So like, oh, he's like,
yeah.
You just said, like he's a mixture of Batman,
Inspired.
Spawn, and
yeah.
Spider-Man.
Like,
that's
is?
What? No.
No Spawn.
No, that's what he said.
No, I was just like, because as an artist, you know, you're like, wow, that's a cool character. I wonder.
Oh,
how
okay. I thought you meant like. Okay, never mind.
No, I was just kind of admiring like, okay, Spawn is a character that never existed before, and Todd McFarlane used to work on Spider-Man, and so I'm like, okay, maybe while he was, I wonder at what point in his career while he was doing illustrating Spider-Man, like I'm gonna create this character
Fair
and
enough,
it's gonna
yeah.
be like dark. You know, and he's going to be agile like Spider-Man because, you know, like I'm just curious about
understand.
The process of creation
in
there, you know. So I'm always making those connections.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
We'll never know until we sit him down, put a light by him and
I'm
you know,
sure
interrogate him.
I think he's talked about that.
He's talked about
yeah.
a little bit. Oh, yeah.
I'm
okay.
not familiar with the whole
I
story.
Should send you guys. There's a cool documentary they made on comics in general, like the start to finish or up to date. And then they have a cool McFarlane section where he talks about being like a new artist. And like going off and starting, I think he started Image, right? Him and a bunch
Image.
Of people.
Yeah.
So basically, that was him, or the how people didn't like his webs, I guess, for some reason.
His webs?
Yeah.
Like the Spider-Man webs?
The webs and like how he illustrated on covers and stuff.
Oh. Okay.
It's a really interesting documentary, but it goes into that.
Okay.
And then it goes, into like Watchmen and then Dark Knight, how the evolution of comics, basically.
Sure.
I definitely will send you guys. It's a really good watch.
Cool.
Is that Netflix?
No, it's on YouTube.
Cool. Even better. I don't have to pay for it.
Free skis.
Free skis.
Cool. These are really delightful, by the way.
Oh, so, hey, on that piece with the tall dude and then
short
the
lady.
I think because you brought in the original and then I remember we were
I think
creating
I still have
the
that one
plaques.
In my garage or somewhere.
And then we were thinking about, like, you didn't have a name for that one. Was that the one you didn't have a name?
Right.
And then
you named that.
What was the name again?
Happy Together.
Because I think like in the background that song was on Happy
Together.
I don't know, something like that. But
what were you thinking when you were making this?
I don't know.
Way?
It was
I like to ask, I know I'm not trying to put you on the spot. If you don't want to talk about it, it's fine.
I had done a sketch a long time ago before I did that, and I kinda just like, why don't I just redraw it?
For some reason I'm getting like have you heard of Lemony Snicket's?
I've heard of it.
Okay, so like the covers remind me of this for some reason.
Okay.
The like just the lengthiness, because they I'm not sure if like if that's a thing of like they exaggerate on lengthiness of arms and legs, but that's what it reminded me. But like, yeah, never mind.
Okay.
It's kind of dark and like saying happy.
Yeah, and it's a very they're very dark children books for some reason.
Oh, okay. Okay. Fair enough.
Not children, yeah, but
that was
what's
a movie adaptation with Jim Carrey, right?
Yeah, a terrible one, yes.
Yeah. Oh, there it is.
Yeah, now they have a Netflix with Neil Patrick Harris.
Oh,
as
cool. Okay, good to know.
It's on Chase's list. Did you guys get that?
So, are you a Pokemon fan as well?
Yeah, when it came out, I was a huge Pokemon fan. But
wait, red or blue?
Oh God, blue.
Sorry, we're not friends.
Oh, okay, whatever.
when you guys said red or blue, I just thought of Morpheus and the pill.
I'm just kidding.
I'm not thinking Pokemon, so.
What starter did we choose?
It depends on the game.
I can't remember. It was really a long time ago. Like, I felt like I was. I mean, like I've restarted that game before, like because I wanted to replay it. What's my favorite starter?
Yeah.
What's your favorite starter?
My favorite starter. God damn it.
Squirtle, Bulbasaur, or Charmander.
It's actually a fire.
Charmander, right?
No, it's.
Over the game. Oh, golden. Quinsel? Cyndaquil.
Cyndaquil is my
favorite. I was pretty close.
Starter.
I like Totodad.
I like Frieza.
That's third, I think.
Third generation.
No,
I always pick Mudkip. I always pick water types. They're just like the best.
It's a good one. That
yeah.
It's like only weak
to. I know we're talking about video games now, but it's whatever.
Well, I mean, it's Pokemon.
Well, no. I meant like, yeah. I was talking about like Pokemon, like show. I was talking about show.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was a huge Pokemon fan, but I grew up in a very religious household.
So they were like, no Pokemon.
They were like, this is same.
Well, Pokemon cards.
I heard it on the news at one time. Yeah. Like, actually, that was funny. Somebody
that makes no sense.
Yeah.
Really? I did not play Pokemon Go.
It was a good waste of time though, but you know.
Wait a second.
For a couple months?
Yeah. I was a hardcore Pokemon Go guy.
Are they?
They
don't care.
Oh, they don't care now.
They
don't care.
They're like, it was ridiculous. They kind of realized that it was a little ridiculous.
Yeah, it was. But I got to meet cool people though while I was doing it.
Oh, I didn't play it, so I never got to meet anybody.
I was like, it was interesting people meter thing. Oh, you playing Pokemon Go? Oh, hey, what's up? Can I have your number? Thanks. Awesome. See you later.
Wow. Maybe I should have.
No, it was like
a dating app. Pokemon Go.
It was kind of like, there's a park in Irvine called Bill Barber. Like everyone that in Southern California area, that was a really hot spot.
Oh.
A big hot spot. It was like people from high school and the colleges around, and then I would drive because my friend lives down the street from it. So I would go over there and he's like, oh, I'm going to Bill Barber. What's this Bill Barber place? Literally about like 100 people just standing out there playing Pokemon Go.
What the heck?
Yeah.
I actually went to go hang out with some of my friends and they did Pokemon Go. I wasn't able to ever get the game. But you know the orange circle?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's the circular area.
That's like the worst place to go, by the way, because it's super unsafe. You can get hit by a car real easy.
Well,
oh yeah, but it's still like I avoided going to circles. I went there one time and I almost got hit because like I was like paying attention and I'm like, I should not. I'm the guy. I'm going back to Bill Barber. There's no cars that can hit me.
There's no cars in the park.
Disneyland got flooded too with that stuff. Geez. Yeah, so
well, it's a good thing I didn't play it then.
Yeah, it was fun though. It was like interesting to go out and like you go out to eat or something like that. You go hang out with friends and then you pop the app open like, oh hey, there's a Charizard out here and like you catch a Charizard.
Oh jeez.
And then someone's like, what are you doing? I'm playing Pokemon Go, dude. Like, don't you know? But it's whatever.
No, not really.
It died really quick, but.
Yeah. But yeah, it would only lasted a couple months, and then, like anything, just kind of died out.
So nobody plays it anymore. Or?
No, I mean, there's people that play it,
but not like to the extent when it first came out.
Right.
I think one of the things was like because they everyone wanted like when's the new the second gen coming out?
Right.
I think they kind of did it too late. So if they would have like done it like a little bit quicker,
it would have saved it. Maybe
it would have helped it. The extent of the lifespan. Because the new Pokemon game actually brought original Pokemon, but they put new twists on it.
Okay.
So I thought that was a good smart. Like I didn't think about that.
They made Muk, but instead of being like all purple, it's like rainbow colored.
Yeah. So like they basically did these crazier ideas with the Pokemon and added like, oh, this one is like now an ice type instead of a fire type or something like that. Yeah, but no.
Oh,
they,
I think I saw that.
They looked not, like the Vulpix, like it was like an all white little like
right.
Was
dog. That, wasn't that what was going on with the Execute?
Yeah, Execute had like a long ass neck.
Wasn't he like a? Is
he's
a, like
dragon
a dragon
now.
Yeah. I'm sorry, but that's ridiculous.
But it was it made sense though, like for the Pokemon app to be around. If they would have extended it to around that time, it would have like because like if you're playing Pokemon Go, I'm like, oh hey guys, you can play the Pokemon and the old Pokemon have like a new look, but you can also yeah, you know what I mean.
No, I understand. It's just I don't know. I think it's I think it's making more convoluted.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Speaking of Pokemon Sun and Moon.
I like how you
I'm
didn't
not.
Want to be on the podcast, but you're talking. But it's okay.
But
well, I mean, you can't have a conversation. You got to ask us questions.
No.
I'm just saying.
Anyway, where were we?
Chase, get up.
We're talking about art.
Pokemon.
Pokemon.
Oh, huge Pokemon fan.
So, what about shows wise? Did you watch like the original? Did you go like to the theaters and watch the movies and everything?
I watched the. I think
first
it was
one?
The first one. The end.
Dude, I cried. Did you cry?
You cried.
I cried.
No,
dude.
I did not.
Ash
cry.
Was like Ash. No.
I went there specifically for the card.
Oh yeah, I got that too. I lost so, it though, but yeah.
I threw it away as
yeah.
soon as.
Like a bit like now you think about like that now like man that'd be kind of cool to just to have like
yeah
I was a part of that
yeah I was a part way. Of that movement at that mm-hmm. point but yeah.
Well,
I
like
went
you're like
card.
About, I would say 4 years older than me. I think you.
I how old are you?
23.
You're a year off.
I'm a year off. So what? Five or three?
Wait, you're 20. What did 23? You say? I already forgot.
23.
Oh no, you're right on.
Four?
Yeah.
No, because I'm thinking because like my sisters were around your age.
Okay.
So that's why, not that I got into Pokemon, but like it helped boost me.
Gotcha.
So like I'm always part of like a generation ahead of me or like not a generation, but like a like, you know, a couple years ahead of me.
Sure, sure.
And like I always feel weird when I talk to people like around my age, even though me and Chase, yeah, nerds, but like regular people that like we were too small to go see Pokemon.
Gotcha.
Or something like that. I'm like,
yeah, yeah.
It's super weird.
Okay.
I feel connected though. It's good.
All right.
Don't touch me.
What are you doing? But Pokemon. Same thing with Yu-Gi-Oh. When Yu-Gi-Oh.
Oh,
so
I don't even want to talk about it.
I actually just downloaded Duel Links, which is like an app for your phone.
For Yu-Gi-Oh?
For Yu-Gi-Oh.
Oh, I got to check that out.
I've only played like the tutorial.
Oh, okay.
But it's decent from what I've seen.
Do you still have your Yu-Gi-Oh cards?
No. No, no, no way.
I have to go check in my garage, but I think I might. I do too.
My brother has both Yu-Gi-Oh and for some reason.
I had an OG Charizard, which is actually pretty expensive these days.
I never had anything valuable in
like
any card game.
Like it was crazy how much like people were paying. Like it's insane.
Hear. It's
there was a Pokemon card that I think that went for like over like $100,000.
Jeez. Whoa!
Yeah. Jeez. It was a cool one. It's a cool card where you got it if you entered this contest. For
oh, like
artists.
Oh.
Yeah, it was an art contest. Whoa. And, like, the top five people or the top whatever people that entered the contest
sure.
and, like, got to be a finalist got a special card.
Whoa.
Or I think either got the card because they participated or a finalist or actually won it. And then that card was, like, an actual Pokemon card you won. And,
okay.
And it was all in Japanese and everything.
Oh, okay.
And so I guess someone sold it. And, like, it's, like, one of the most valuable cards out there for
jeez.
Some reason.
Only, like, 5-run print.
Yeah, or something like a very few, very
okay.
few amount.
Limited run.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah, but I was never into that kind. I played the game to play the game.
Mm-hmm.
Never a collector kind of deal.
Yeah.
Same with comics. I read to read them.
Dude, you can make a lot of money off like basic, like the stuff that's coming out. Like if you get special issues and stuff,
yeah,
you can
I
make
hear.
Money off. It's
yeah.
crazy.
But that's kind of what the whole isn't that why comics kind of crashed in like the 90s?
Oh right, because
I'm not too sure.
Yeah, because
yeah.
they were like, they were printing more than people were buying, and at some point, everybody was buying what everybody thought was like collector items.
Oh, okay.
Like it was basically worthless, and so the comic industry kind of crashed.
So then they just shot themselves in the foot. Then.
Yeah, yeah, basically.
Okay, cool.
So
I didn't know that. I gotta like.
Yeah, get in on that history, man. I don't. Well, I mean, I'm kind of doing comics, so I kind of
yeah.
have to know.
I did. I totally didn't know. That. I know there was a crash. I didn't know like the reason for the crash.
Yeah, it was just like overprinting.
I thought it was just a saturation of like just new comics.
No, it's just I mean, a lot of
like
people
there's like five issues. There's five different stories of like Superman. Who wants to read all five of those?
I mean, that I would assume that too.
Yeah,
but like a lot of people were making a lot of money, just kind of selling and trading, and they weren't comic fans. They were there for the money.
Yeah,
and it's they. I guess the company saw that as like, oh, we're having a lot of sales, so we should print more. And at some point, they just overprinted all the like limited super foil covers.
Sounds like there wasn't a business person in charge.
Yeah, no. Yeah. I don't think so.
Like there's just like someone's like, oh, I'm just here. Cool.
Or there was a corrupt business person.
Well, I don't know.
Yeah. Maybe they just. Maybe. They were blind, maybe. But I mean, it's everything. Everyone's kind of blind when you think about that's it. Like, about stuff. Like, there's always a crash.
Do you think it'll ever
something.
Happen again in the comedy? I mean, like, I don't know too much about what's happening now. So.
No, I don't think so. At the rate it's going, I don't think so. I think I think the industry is kind of.
They're smart
from
enough.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah. But there. I mean, DC and Marvel will always come out with like that kind of alternative comic,
mm-hmm.
and that's sort of mirroring what happened.
Mm.
So I kind of have to be worried about
like a lot of variants.
Yeah, variants. That's what I was talking about.
Yeah.
So variants is kind of doing what the limited edition kind
but, of. But I think that what makes those variants a little bit more special, though, from what I'm hearing, is that it's a certain artist that does that variant. So
right.
People like so. Yeah.
Right. Right. But like they're. The variants are way more valuable than the ones that usually come out.
So yeah, it's like the first five issues that are like the original issues that are most expensive.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, people will buy them up and then sell them somewhere.
Right. Calm down. We're going to, I was about to get to that. I know where you're pointing at. No, because I was, for in the first issue of Saga is like $200.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I want one though.
I don't.
I just want to have it. Like, I want, like, back, like, the actual original issues
okay.
for me.
Yeah, okay.
Because I have it in volumes. That's all.
Okay. Okay. I actually enjoy volumes more than I do single issues.
That's, so, yeah, I like the idea, but, like, for, like, something I really enjoyed for, some, like,
sure.
reading, I just want to, like, cool.
Kind of, like, the whole card thing, kind of, like, I was part of that.
But that's only, I only want the first issue. I don't want issue two.
Oh, okay.
Like, if it's just got issue one, I'd be satisfied.
Okay.
But like I would like to attempt to have like every issue.
Okay, fair enough. Okay.
But like
so if you like Spawn, did you ever, I mean you collect Pokemon cards? Did you ever collect like
Spawn cards?
They had Spawn
cards?
Trading, but they weren't that big.
I don't
know. You guys remember Pogs?
They had like
yeah,
I'm sorry.
Pogs,
sorry
man.
To interrupt you.
They had Marvel Universe Marvel Universe Series 1, Series 2, like the trading cards. And like each card had like one character on it, and on the back of the card it had like okay, strength is 7, you know, agility.
I think I've seen those,
yeah.
But I never got into that.
I used to get a lot of those. They actually had a Punisher trading card series, and like they had foil editions were the special ones.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they also had one like it was another special card in the deck that if you're lucky you got it. It was a scratch and sniff.
What?
Yeah, it's like there was a card where Punisher has his Uzi and like there's smoke coming out of it and there's these crystals.
You smell the smoke?
Yeah, you would. The
that's
card
actually
kind of
cool.
Like smoke.
Actually,
I have one. I'll bring it in. I'll show you.
It's
pretty odd. The scratch and sniff. It's like
I remember my brother having like X-Men and like Marvel cards and stuff.
Okay.
I never like got in like I didn't make any sense to have those, but yeah.
I got into Magic.
You did? Oh, I'm kind of jealous.
Like no, not I got into Magic like
cause
for a small
like
amount of time.
Is it a fun game to play?
From what I remember, it is. It's very similar to Yu-Gi-Oh, sort of. Like, the fundamentals are
okay.
sort of similar. But, like, it can get kind of convoluted.
So, Arlyn.
Yes, sir.
So, I think my brother was actually the first hybrid of what we were talking about the last podcast about being, like, a nerd and also being, like, doing sports.
Right.
Because he was born the same year, I think, 81.
Yeah.
And so, he was very much, like, into sports, playing video games and stuff.
Yeah.
And then, like, he was in the military, and, like, him and his military buddies up in Fort Nellis or Nellis Air Space or whatever.
Sure.
Yeah.
Up in Vegas.
Yeah.
They would play, like, in between, like, shifts or something like that up there. They would play Magic cards.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay.
So I thought that was kind of, like, I was like, wait, what? Like, you and, like, other, like, adults that are in the military play Magic cards. And it's like,
that's
yeah,
awesome.
Like, we do that, like, even when we're working sometimes because we get bored.
When
like,
they get together. They might
like,
even
what?
Get together and play WoW, too, probably.
Yeah,
right?
He does. Yeah,
there
he did
go.
Play WoW.
I already knew it. I guessed it.
Was it Warcraft?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Just checking.
Is that old now?
I don't know.
I mean, yeah.
It's
like,
of, yeah.
Now it's Overwatch, right?
Oh.
I mean, just recently.
Yeah.
I enjoy that game. It's really competitive.
I haven't played it.
You have to find like a character. That
oh, I mean, I know what it's about.
Well, you know, no, I meant like you won't enjoy it if you don't find a character that you really enjoy playing as,
okay.
And then if you don't have friends to play with, there's like no point in playing.
Oh, okay, it's kind of like multiplayer. Kind
yeah,
of
it's just deal. All straight. I mean, I think they have somewhat of a single player game.
Oh, but it's
something.
Better multiplayer than that.
Yeah, it's built for multiplayer.
Okay,
it's like Team Fortress or like
never played it.
Have you played like a LoL? League of Legends.
Nope.
Never mind. I'm not trying to compare, but like it's like has that
no,
good
I know,
atmosphere.
I know like how those work, but like I've never played them.
Yeah, it's fine.
But I know what the deal is.
Mm.
So online gaming,
interesting. I'm actually writing skits about that stuff, but it's
okay,
cool.
On I hear you you live stream on Twitch.
Oh yes.
Oh yeah, I kind of
let's
talk
about that.
I started last year, like in the summer.
You don't know what you're like. You might be onto something, by the way.
What do you mean?
Because like there's like talk shows starting to be on Twitch and stuff.
Right.
That's not gaming.
Sure.
So like I think like the artist thing is a really cool thing to do.
Right. I actually got banned from Twitch.
What?
What?
Like I think the second time I streamed.
For what?
I was totally not aware of the whole nudity. Cause I was
so
drawing.
You get naked while you draw.
Like, so you can't draw that kind of stuff.
Well, didn't they give you a warning?
No, they just up and ban you.
So wait, you were doing like figure drawing.
Yeah, figure drawing.
And they
so you be wary.
That is
they should have sent you a warning like hey yo.
Oh, I mean, I'm sure they did or I don't know if they did, but I wasn't paying attention.
Okay, that's your fault.
That's my fault. But yeah, by the time I finished the painting, I was like, "Oh, you've been banned." I went back to the screen. I'm like, "Oh, okay."
Cuz like Facebook, I mean, you know, like as far as the issue of nudity, I know it's like if you're doing an art piece and it's artistically tasteful, I guess. Like, you know, but Twitch doesn't have that. Then I guess they're just like nope,
it's just kind of strict. I don't know about Facebook because sometimes they even ban.
Well, funny, I did a figure drawing piece and I did get a warning, but the warning didn't come from Facebook. It was just Facebook basically said somebody flagged your thing, and
I think it's only if someone complains about it.
No, check this out. Somebody complained about it and Facebook got the notification and Facebook notified me and said, hey, somebody flagged it. And and is saying that you're going against the policy of Facebook, but Facebook says replied to that and said, no, you're not. So you still get to keep your picture up there of your naked drawing.
Yeah.
And the girl, you know, the drawing was a full nude drawing, and
are you talking about the pictures that you post?
Yeah, like the nude finger drawings. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
this
yeah.
was like a fully rendered, you know, piece.
I remember that one.
And then I reposted it, and I don't know who flagged it, but it was just like, dude, you know,
wait,
whoever.
Did you post it with a Chris Farley?
I did.
You
yeah,
did?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
I totally
Chris Farley
that
with the Chippendale.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, like in your face. You know, come on now. You know, it's just like I'm not posting like you know. Like in a pro, you know, and it's just it's art, you know.
Sure.
And there's been the nude figure since Renaissance, or even before that.
People
so
get over that kind of stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just damn millennial kids, Jesus.
Yeah.
Grow up.
there is another live streaming site that actually doesn't care about that kind of stuff.
What's it called?
Picarto.
Never heard of it.
So
keep going.
Yeah, it's fairly new from what I hear.
Okay.
So, but it's all artist kind of community.
Oh, that's cool. Okay.
So it's only art. You can only do art there.
So I can't be like
playing games?
No, like this if I wanted to talk. Maybe if I wanted to talk about art.
I don't know. You'd have to maybe talk to them.
Okay, cool.
You might be okay with it. Or
so do you stream on that?
I've streamed a couple of times. I haven't because I kind of got back on Twitch.
You needed to we needed exchange numbers so I can start to link this stuff to you
so
the video and stuff.
So but right now your Twitch account is not active.
No, the Twitch is active. Yeah, a month later I was like, okay, can I get back on Twitch or something? And
right.
It was fine.
And they're okay.
But after that, it kind of left a sour taste in my mouth. Basically.
Yeah.
And so I went to Picarto for a while.
Okay.
And then I stopped completely because. You know, things get in the way.
What I suggest to you to do is doing Overwatch art. And you'll get a fan base, trust me. Or doing, like, if you look up LOL and, like, Dota characters and you start drawing them. I'm just saying, like, doing that, like, once a week.
Sure.
You're going to get, I'm pretty sure you'll get a following. Like,
a really
good following. Because people are like, oh, my God, this guy drills this. And they'll start requesting stuff. But, like, you could do your other stuff. But I'm saying, like, I would suggest... Do your awesome stuff and then throw like a little bit of lull in there.
Yeah, I think artists have to kind of do that. Just like follow the trends.
Yeah.
Kind of deal.
Well, no, that's like the only trend. Like it's either lull, Overwatch, and Dota stuff that's being streamed and stuff. That's what I'm just suggesting.
No, that's a good suggestion.
That's what I'm saying. You're like onto something. You just
right.
need to like.
Sure.
You know what I'm talking
about. So, yeah, I've been doing a lot of that lately. A lot of digital stuff. I'm trying to do a lot more traditional stuff because I've been doing. Traditional for a while. I've been doing it for my whole life, obviously.
Yeah.
But I've kind of wanting to step away from digital, not completely, but just kind of go back to like a fundamentals and ink and pen kind of deal.
You want to feel it.
Yeah. Okay. It's I don't know. There's a feeling to it when you create it with your hands, like physical hands. Obviously.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying. So Chase. No, I'm just kidding.
No offense to any digital artists. Yeah. Honestly, because there's some really good digital artists out there. So, but yeah, I do that every once in a while. I did one last night. So it's up.
How long does it? So for a piece, how long do you think it would take you to
complete it?
To complete it, like I'm talking about a pre-production. Like you have an idea of what you want, or you just gotta go free ball it and like.
It kind of depends on what's being done.
Okay.
If
what about something like that we showed?
This took like a day maybe.
And then what versus the Twitch stuff?
Versus the Twitch. The Twitch stuff was just kind of.
Is it like a progress thing?
Yeah, it's kind of work in progress. It's not finished at the moment.
Okay.
So, most of them end with a work kind of like not unfinished, and then I end up posting the finished work at my social media.
Okay.
Kind of deal.
I think I follow you on Instagram, right?
I don't know.
Do you have Instagram?
I do.
Okay. Well, hey, we're gonna
link everything.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's gonna be linked, but yeah.
So
I'm pretty sure I do. I'm not too sure.
I don't know if you do.
Because I remember you mentioned that. Okay, we had a weird conversation, and I think I asked, like, do you have an Instagram? And you're like, yeah.
Well, yeah. I mean, everything's on my space.
I know. Gallery. No, I think we know. Like, we had a conversation. Like,
did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, thanks for remembering our conversation, but whatever.
Yeah,
it's okay.
Sure. It was very quick, though. I don't think it was very long.
We haven't really had a conversation like this.
Yeah. So.
Yes. Awkward sound.
So what's in the next in the works? Are you working on a personal piece at the moment?
Yeah. Well, the one I was working on last night on Twitch is... Oh, I should actually... I got into wrestling again in the last
WWE. Wait, no. WWE, TNA, PWG.
Drawing wrestlers or actually wrestling somebody?
Point, you know, when I told you that I kind of just stepped back from the whole comics thing.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I
are you attitude era guy? I'm guessing.
Or are you know, I look back on it and it wasn't as good as I remember.
I didn't like The Rock as much. That's the one I think about it now. I didn't like The Rock.
It's not. I think everybody sees it with nostalgia kind of lenses, and a lot of it was really bad.
So are you a WCW guy?
No.
Okay.
I never watched WCW.
Okay.
So I was never. I didn't care about the Monday Night Wars. When it was around.
Okay.
So, and then I realized that ECW was a thing at the time, and I was like, oh, I totally missed out on ECW. But yeah, I got back into it last year during WrestleMania.
So, who's your favorite wrestler at the moment?
Ooh, god dang. That's
Is it a new guy or is it an old guy?
It's veteran right now. SmackDown champion AJ Styles.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, because like I'm an indie. I like indie guys, and like I really much support.
Yeah, I've been watching a lot of indie.
Oh, do you watch NXT?
Oh yeah, NXT. Okay. I'm subscribed to the.
Okay. Network, so. Take my $9.99.
And then I'm also subscribed to High Spots.
What's that?
And they do PWG.
Oh, okay. I've been trying to look for a place to watch PWG because I don't want to spend the money to go for those tickets. I heard they're really expensive now.
They sell out with like
2 hours. Exactly.
So, and they're just in Reseda.
Mm.
They're so close.
And then there's another one by Frankincense as well.
Oh,
there's another.
I wasn't sure.
There's another organization. It's got them, and then I think PWG is like right above them. Or right around Ring of Honor. You know Ring of Honor.
I know Ring of Honor.
And then, there's. WWE is like above them, obviously.
Yeah. I've been watching a lot of indies, a lot of like kind of shoot interviews kind of deal. So they'll sit the wrestler down and just talk about like their experience.
Do you watch like anyone on YouTube that covers it?
Flow Slam. Well,
I've heard of Flow Slam. I do and No DQ. Do you, No
oh,
DQ
I'm not,
and A.
I'm not sure. I'm
I would check. Sure. He's like a really not analyzes, but he's a really good expert on like this stuff, and like I understand it more. As a business, and then like understanding it for like why are they doing this?
Right.
This is why. I'm like, okay.
God damn it. The guys from England. Have their own WCPW. I don't know if you're.
I have to check that out now. We have to exchange this stuff. I didn't know you're a wrestling fan. That's awesome.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, I don't really talk about it.
What? There's nothing to be embarrassed.
It's no. There's nothing to be. It's just it's hard to find somebody to talk about it. Everybody's like, oh. Overwatch. So yeah, but I got back into it just to see what's going on.
So you saw Age of Styles. Is that the first time you saw him, or you saw?
No, I was familiar with Age of Styles. Okay. I never watched TNA back in the day. Mm. I had a friend who
was actually on WCW, if you didn't know that as well.
Oh, yeah, I'm familiar. Okay, he was in WCW for like the last few tapings. Yeah, exactly. They went off the air and got bought out by WWE. Anyway, yeah. So I was aware of Age of Styles from not back in the back in the day, back when TNA was kind of the coming out.
Yeah,
I had a friend who would order the pay per views. And he would tell me about it and be like, oh, Jeff Hardy's there. Because I had realized Jeff Hardy had left WWE at that time.
Okay. Yeah, a lot of people see it. They're like, wait, what? He doesn't know? Like, yeah, he wrestles
with TNA. Yeah, yeah. I'm like, what's TNA? And then so Age of Styles, Samoa Joe, Christopher Daniels.
I'm blanking on the name right now. I'll remember, there's a wrestler, I just can't remember his name right now.
Around that era kind of deal?
Yeah, like original guy.
The Undertaker.
No. We're talking about TNA.
Speaking of the Undertaker. No.
Well, I know RVD went over there and stuff, and Christian went over there.
Kurt Angle?
Kurt Angle went over there. No, I'm thinking about, I can't remember.
Is he like a TNA original kind of deal?
I think he was. He had to have been. I forgot his name. Jeez.
Amazing Red?
Didn't have a
Jerry Lynn.
I'll remember it. Keep going. No, keep going about the conversation.
Jeez. So yeah, just a lot right now. It's just a lot of indie. So I'm a SmackDown guy right now.
Mm. Raw hasn't been. Once Daniel Bryan and Shane McMahon take that over, man, so the camera angles they do now, the even commentary is all right, but it's doable. But like,
it's better than.
Yeah, definitely.
But I got in because I saw Kevin Owens.
Oh, KO.
KO. I have a shirt. I should have worn it.
I have a Seth Rollins. I'm a Seth Rollins guy. Okay. Sorry.
I didn't really follow his stuff until he came back from the injury.
Mm-hmm. I was like super into Seth Rollins for some reason. Like when he was back into the actually. Right before S.H.I.E.L.D. came to the main show.
Oh, okay.
That's when I heard about them. I looked it up. He was if you didn't know, CM Punk was supposed to be like the leader of the S.H.I.E.L.D. S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, I hear. Yeah, okay. Yeah, him. It was supposed to be him, Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose, and Chris Hero.
I think so, yeah.
Or Cassius Ohno, as he is known. He came back like a couple of weeks ago.
Okay, I have to check that out. I don't watch as much as I used to. Oh, okay. I'll because my stepdad, he's like, he watches it every week.
Sure.
So like I'll pop in. I'm like, okay, what are we watching? Okay. This guy, okay. What happened in the last pay-per-view? Okay. This happened. Okay. Yeah. Good.
Oh, well, anyway, that's a super tangent I just went on. Yeah. But yeah, a lot of wrestling. So the piece I was doing live streaming last night, has to deal with, Asuka, the NXT women's champion at the moment.
She's pretty badass.
Oh, super badass.
Yeah, I've seen, her, and I think she took this title from Bayley, right?
Yeah. At, Dallas. Last year?
Mm. Have you gone to the NXT show yet?
No.
I wanted to go to the Palladium one. They had one at the Palladium.
That I heard. I didn't go, though.
Yeah.
I hardly have time to go anywhere, unfortunately. I did a piece on her and the recent match she's going to have next week.
You should tweet at her, by the way.
I will. Yeah. Once the piece is done, I'm going to post it all.
I'm just saying, also, you might want to do a Seth Rollins one, because if he sees something like that, he's gonna give you a good shout out. I've seen him do awesome shout outs on Twitter. He's a really active guy on Twitter.
He's going to have a new theme song at WrestleMania.
Really?
Well, it's gonna be similar, but like, it's going to be a different. It's going to be an actual band.
Oh, okay. He's into that, like, I forgot what band it is, because his logo is like some bands. He kind of not ripped it off, but like I think he asked them
similar.
Before.
Yeah,
so very similar. It's like S7 or something like that.
I have no idea.
But like he's into like hardcore. Like,
oh yeah. I hear. I saw his documentary when he was coming back.
Okay.
So I'll take the chance and watch who the Seth Rollins guy is, because he was like a champion and then he got injured or whatever.
Really good, amazing wrestler. I really enjoy his stuff.
But yeah, so doing a piece on Asuka and the match she's going to have at the new takeover next week against three other people. Yes,
because I know they
Billy Kay, Peyton Royce, and Nikki Cross.
Because they've already grabbed up like all those girls, basically, and moved them up to the roster.
Yeah, they called up everybody but Asuka.
Yeah.
Is Asuka, I mean, I don't know, is she Japanese?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
cool. Well, they have her, and then they have, what's his name? He's been going to have that feud with Samoa Joe.
Nakamura,
there
Shinsuke
you go.
Shinsuke Nakamura. Ooh.
But WWE is going to doing a good thing with, like, grabbing talent from... But like,
I think they're doing... Oh, I think it's fine.
Yeah.
The whole Nakamura deal was... New Japan, I follow New Japan as well. So New Japan just kind of like they do 1 year contracts, and Nakamura didn't like that, so he kind of just didn't re-sign with them.
Yeah,
and so WWE kind of stepped in and like, hey, we want you for NXT. And he's like, okay, cool.
Well, I think eventually he'll get up to the main roster. Eventually,
I hope.
Because I think Samoa Joe, there's a rumor that Samoa Joe is going to he'll be a surprise entrance for
the
Royal
Rumble.
Sure. The thing, like, and then another match people really want to push is Samoa Joe versus Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, I don't know how that's going to go over, but I mean.
I think it would be a good match because I think Samoa Joe can still do amazing things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just, he's, I feel like he's being kind of wasted in NXT at this point.
Yeah, but I just like, I think for WWE, because the business standpoint, they have to like pay their dues. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but he's been there for like a year and a half.
I know, but it's just
like
the way it is.
How long was Sami Zayn though?
But that's like another thing. They'll bring a new guy and like they'll be
and
like
then have like the W retrain them for the WWE.
Yeah,
because
they
style.
Have to be like kind of not rebranded, but they have to like follow
retrain
and, like, yeah.
sort of for
yeah.
the style. Yeah, yeah.
What's up?
We got a question.
Very random question for Chase. Go ahead.
What well? What are you on
what
about?
What is this well talk? Are you just trying to like have us not talk about WWE right now?
No.
We can we'll move on if you want.
Yeah, we're pretty much done.
Yeah.
So if you had a reserve cannibalism, you're in a
well. So we're in a well. We're talking about if we would eat each other if we got stuck in a well.
Yeah. Who's
Arlyn in the whale
there?
Too?
Who's there? Who are the people?
Just real options.
Who are the people there?
It's us three.
Just
I think.
Us three.
I think we would figure out how to get out first, and I think we would be able to figure it out.
Yeah, I think so.
We would do the GI Joe. Have you seen?
We would do
the GI Joe thing where we have back to backs and we would climb up the wall, going up.
That's not a bad idea.
It isn't. It's safer.
Much safer than eating.
Yeah. Sorry, Arlyn, for being. We were talking about something you don't even know.
Oh, dude, no worries. No, I was listening because I don't know too much about wrestling and stuff, but I used to watch it in the 80s with my cousin. And then we'd switch from playing Punch Out to watching The Undertaker to watching The Hulk.
He's still around.
Yeah, see, I think I talked to
he's
him.
He's only he does like one or two matches a year, really.
How old is that guy?
He's like at least almost 60.
Jeez, man.
But
yeah, but like Ric Flair was still going when.
Woo!
I don't know.
It depends. But like, he has a difference. I think like. The Undertaker's like style isn't the same because he used to be way more athletic. Obviously,
sure,
Ric Flair was not like as athletic. He had like he knew like the wrestling techniques and how to
bump.
Yeah,
without like being.
That's another thing I hear. Real quick though, is like, do you prefer like an acrobatic style or more of a trying to look more realistic?
Strong style kind of.
Yeah, thing? like
whatever WWE is doing at this point.
Yeah, like where like someone gets hit, but like he didn't get hit, and they're obviously trying to avoid injuries. Do you like that?
I'm totally okay with them protecting the other wrestler.
Okay, cool.
I think I don't know. There's a lot of people that want the blood back, and I'm like,
yeah.
It could be saved for like
certain events.
Curtain,
yeah, like
special occasions.
Have you seen the thumbtacks with Chris Jericho?
Yeah, 96 tacks. But I don't think it should be. I think wrestlers at this moment are much more protected, and that's a good thing.
Yeah,
because there's a lot of talent out there now.
Mm.
But like, I'm a fan of any style, strong style, WWE style, luchador, British.
It's crazy, like how like this is like a, it's like MMA in a way. Kind Like, I hate all people are like, oh, it's fake. I'm like, yeah, but there's like.
It's
entertaining, but like, you don't understand. Like, they actually get hurt still.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Like, Finn Balor. Like,
oh, yeah.
Tore his rotator cuff or something like that. Yeah.
Sucks for him.
Yeah.
Wins the title and then gets stripped. Yeah. Next but, I'm. As long as it's entertaining.
Yes. Okay.
I mean, there's some very, very well done comedy matches. I mean, like I said, it's just as long as it's entertaining, I'm fine with it. It
keeps you awake.
Yeah.
All right.
So you guys know it's fake. So do you guys? But you guys,
I mean,
still
a
see it entertaining.
Fake.
No.
They have stuntmen.
I was getting to like. So you kind of see it as like an SNL skit.
I see it as like
okay.
a reality
okay.
show.
Yeah, yeah.
I right. see it more as a reality show for me.
Okay. Fair
all
enough.
Right. Cool. Right on.
But yeah. Just because it's fake doesn't mean you can't be entertained by it.
Yeah. The characters are cool.
Oh yeah. I mean, most of them. Sometimes they're.
Well, there was a cool point. I saw a interview real quick about with Randy Orton.
Sure.
And he talked about comparing hit like the WWE to the UFC. So UFC is like unpredictable, obviously. You don't
sure.
know about your main event. But for WWE, you know like your main event, you're going to get a main event. You know what I mean?
Right.
So you're going to get your money's worth regardless.
Sure.
In a way. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The idea. Like with, but like the difference between MMA is like, you know, you never know. Like the guy might get knocked out, or boxing, you might get knocked out like instantly.
Right.
So then you're like, that's it then? Like,
right. That's like, kind of what happened with the whole Goldberg-Lesnar match.
I didn't get to watch that.
It was like a minute long.
So who won?
Goldberg.
Okay, so he did win. Okay.
Yeah.
That's what I heard.
Yeah.
I didn't watch it, though.
Oh, yeah. It was a quick match.
Okay, dope.
Nobody expected it. I didn't expect it. I watched him like, that was it? It was like a minute long.
What is the Goldberg match, though, when you
yeah,
think about it?
I mean, I think that their first. I think they had a first match a while ago, and it was a complete dud. Everybody booed.
Oh.
So, I mean, this kind of.
Made sense.
It played to their strengths,
mm-hmm.
and all for some reason people didn't like it. Well, I mean, whatever.
Yeah.
So, anyway.
So it seems like you guys really like wrestling. Do you think you'd ever integrate it into like your comic?
There's actually a lot of merchandise in wrestling.
Oh,
there's
especially
a ton.
In indie independent promotions.
Independent.
Yeah.
So that's
okay.
kind of what I've been trying to do.
Oh, okay. All
so right. I've trying to. I mean, if any wrestlers out there.
Seth Rollins, hi. I love you, man.
yeah.
Dean Ambrose.
So, I mean, I want to design for that kind of stuff.
Mm.
I mean, not specifically. Well, not
specifically, but like for.
But I'd like to branch out in that kind of.
That's
deal.
Cool.
I didn't know there was so much merchandise.
There is.
Until
There's
I saw shirts and.
Well, like, they changed their logo like every like
oh,
three
yeah.
months.
Yeah.
And then, like.
So, I mean, if I can get. Somehow break there. I mean, I'm trying to break in there and the comic book industry,
mm-hmm.
but I mean, I think it's good to have your hands in a bunch of pies.
Yeah, but it's also something that you enjoy, so it's also like it's benefiting you because like, oh, now you're getting not only you're
yeah,
feet in the door,
it, so
you're
I mean,
in the fan,
like
and like you're not just doing it for like just for a living. You're
sure.
also doing it because
you're
a fan.
It.
You
yeah.
enjoy it.
Yeah.
You want to be part of. You're a part of the community already.
Right. So, I think at that, but I'd have to go out to events. And kind of just meet the wrestlers,
because
I actually follow a guy who kind of does that.
Okay.
He'll well, I mean, he'll do like portraits of like the wrestlers.
Oh, okay.
Go meet them and just like give it to them, and he gets commissions from people who want specific wrestlers.
Oh, okay.
And so
that's
nice.
Dope.
I think it's I'll just plug his Instagram. I think it's Off the Heart.
Off the Heart.
The guy is amazing.
He's amazing.
He's like a watercolor.
Okay.
Guy.
That sounds dope. I'm
gonna
check that out.
Amazing. I'll link you later, but. Yeah.
You so know who's also, there's also another great artist on Instagram called Omar Osegreda. oh, shit, he's right here.
Oh, look.
Oh, man.
Damn, we got him on the podcast.
He's on Instagram too, right?
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm pretty much everywhere.
Instagram, Twitter, Facebook.
Tumblr.
You have your own Tumblr.
I have my own website.
Have
his
own
I
website.
Still have a DeviantArt if you're still on that.
I don't know what that is, but go check that
yeah,
out.
Yeah. So I guess it's going down.
Damn. Yeah, yeah. I'm old school, in that sense. That was around high school.
It's still a. I don't know the how many people more people use it. Is it's gonna die down?
Yeah, still a community in there, but I don't post much. I have it to have it just in case.
I'm thinking right now, guys, outside the box. Might benefit you, benefit me, benefit Arlyn.
Yes.
So prepare to stop inviting me to a
yeah.
It was a while back. They had like an industry thing.
Yeah.
Would it be cool if we had like an industry kind of meetup with a bunch of people here?
Oh.
Think about that.
Oh.
So
yeah.
like promoters, we would try to get promoters to come and like we all talk and interact and exchange and stuff for the beginning of the year. Or I mean like down the line maybe too.
Sure.
Think about it. Chase is just thinking about money over there.
He's the money guy.
But I'm just saying that'd be kind of an interesting thing to do.
Yeah.
So like I'm saying, like you might find that wrestling connection.
Oh yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe we'll think about that.
We got plenty of chairs they could use.
I know.
They still use chairs, right?
Oh yeah. Well, I mean certain promotions too.
Yeah. CZW. Or just throw it into the ring. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Massive pile of chairs. So. I think we are at the end of the episode, right? It's been about an hour.
It's been about an hour.
Guys,
so,
wow.
So to close, where do you see, what do you have for in store for us in the future for your artwork, Omar? Or plans, you know?
Plans.
Any
comic books?
Wrestling? Comics, short stories kind of deal. So more wrestling or
more wrestling oriented stuff, yeah.
What else? Jeez.
More inking? I mean, like, you seem to just inking
just a
seems
I'm a,
to dominate.
I'm a
yeah.
kind of, like, ink and pen kind of dude. So a lot more of that. More pieces for the shows, for the gallery.
Nice.
Yeah. Actually, just I mean, like, whatever kind of tickles my fancy.
Going with the flow, right?
Going with the flow, nice. Yeah. So, I mean,
it's not a bad
whatever,
thing.
Whatever
it's a good
I feel
thing.
Like,
yeah.
I'll do. Nice. So. Hopefully a lot more art than last year. Last year it was just kind of a transition from college to the real world kind of deal.
Okay. Yeah.
And so now I kind of I found my footing somewhat. Nice. So hopefully this year I can produce a lot more than I did last year.
You're ready for it.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
You're more prepared.
Yeah. So.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Dude, that's
jealous.
Awesome.
Jealous.
Jelly.
So, I think that is the end of the podcast, Arlyn. I know you didn't really talk much, but...
Oh, no, I was listening. This was a good learning experience for me, you know. I'm like that...
we didn't get to talk about music, actually. Never mind. Sorry,
oh,
go ahead.
Dude.
Yeah. Maybe next time we'll have you again. Well, for sure.
I can talk for days about music.
That's another. That's what we should have did.
I was mentally preparing...
For music?
I have gum in my hand. In my hand? I was chewing gum, so that came out weird. But I was mentally preparing to say my top five albums.
You have still time. Go ahead.
Yeah,
go
ahead.
Yeah.
Top five, everyone.
Top five.
Top five.
I mean,
all times.
No, not all time.
Okay, for this.
It changes.
Right now. Okay, right now.
It changes. So right now is Twilight Sad. Nobody wants to be here and nobody wants
you
to
you need
leave.
To tell me this, the music, because I like listening to any music.
It's very electronic kind of goth. Dark wave kind of deal.
Have you heard of Magical Clouds?
No.
Okay, never mind.
It's kind of like The Cure.
Ooh,
okay.
Sort of. That kind of deal.
Wait. Is it like Crystal Castle?
No. No. It's like early Cure kind of deal.
Okay.
And synth. It's. I mean, they just finished a tour with The Cure.
Okay.
Whoa,
and The
okay,
Cure was
so
like,
nice.
If this was any other, if they were us when we were coming out, these guys would be outselling us.
Oh, okay.
So The Cure are huge fans of these guys.
Oh, okay. That's dope.
So,
dude, that's awesome.
So yeah, I've been a huge fan for a while now, and it's good to see like them finally start getting recognition.
What are they called again?
The Twilight Sad.
The Twilight Sad.
Yeah.
All right. Nothing to do with the movie Twilight.
No.
Right? Okay.
Thankfully not.
Nothing to do with the movie yeah. Sad. No, I'm just kidding.
Is the movie Sad?
I don't know.
Oh, I'll look into that. So that one, geez.
You said you prepared. No, I'm just kidding.
I was prepared, but all this talk completely. Behemoth the Satanist.
Oh, nice. All right.
So like
it's
heavy
a,
metal.
It's a black metal.
Black metal.
So it's very good. It's family friendly.
Okay.
But yeah. It's they're from Poland, I think.
So they speak
and
Polish?
The guy wrote it. After he was diagnosed with cancer.
Oh wow! Okay.
And
now I want to listen to this.
He. It was just kind of like if I go out, this is kind of like my
hurrah, last hurrah,
almost like a David Bowie kind of thing.
And he
right?
finished yeah. it. Like he was diagnosed, he survived it, and he finished it. And he felt like a lot of artists kind of go to Jesus after that kind of experience. And he was, if anything, he was firmly rooted in his beliefs after the whole fact. So it's kind of refreshing to kind of see a different perspective instead of like the usual I found Jeebus kind of deal. But
I did drugs and found them.
I found them through drugs.
Yeah.
But yeah, and if you're into metal, I'd totally check that out.
So what's dark metal? I mean, like
black metal.
Black metal. Sorry, black metal.
Okay, wait, guys. I don't want to be a dick, but like we're gonna run out on time.
Next podcast
for sure. We'll talk about dark metal. Yeah,
black metal. Right.
So Behemoth, Angel Olsen, My Woman, who's kind of like a folk artist at the moment.
Like folk.
So I was just playing it on the way over here.
Okay.
So that ASAP Rock. The Impossible Kid, the latest one. Either that or Labor Days. And number five.
Ooh. We're talking about the same ASAP Rock that's spelled like a
ASAP Rock.
Okay.
Not ASAP Rocky.
No, okay.
Yeah. Guy from, I think he's from New York.
I'm not sure. I like his voice.
Yeah.
He's
so good. So good. who else? Jeez. Hold on. Let me look through my phone real quick. I've been listening to a lot of bands lately. Jeez. Give me a second. Not a theoretical second. Not a real second. Jeez.
Okay. Hi, guys. Hi.
Mogwai.
Mogwai.
The Returned, I think. They're a Scottish. They're from the same country Twilight Saturn's on.
Okay.
On. From. They did this album for a French show.
Okay.
Kind of like a sci-fi horror show about people who come back from the dead and they kind of trying to reintegrate in society when society kind of like their families have moved on.
Okay.
But yeah. It's just instrumental the whole time. It's
very
it's
peaceful.
Very atmospheric.
Okay.
Kind of for Halloween kind of deal.
Oh, so, okay. That actually sounds pretty interesting.
Yeah.
I don't listen to a lot of instrumental, but yeah.
But yeah, Mogwai, Twilight Sad, Behemoth, Angel Olsen, ASAP Rock. For now.
I'm glad I at least I know one of those guys for sure. But yes. And I think that's it.
Yeah.
Right?
I think so.
Cool. Yeah.
So this has been the Arlyn Pillay Podcast at the Arlyn Pillay Art Gallery. I am Richard Radio. To my far left, that's the man, the myth, the legend, Arlyn Pillay. And Omar, I'm not going to say your last name because it's really hard to say.
Osegueda.
Oh, there you go.
Osegueda.
It's all about the D.
Okay. Anyways.
I mean,
but go ahead and check us out.
The D, not the R. Not the R. Cut that last part. No, I'm joking.
Go ahead and like, share, subscribe, guys. Go ahead and tell us how we're doing in the comments down below. Go ahead and check out Omar and all the social media links in the description down below. Go check out mine and Arlen's social media links in the description down below as well. And that's it, guys. Thank you for being here. And until next time, for sure, we're going to have you again because we have unfinished business.
Maybe we'll get some of you doing some artwork over here.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
We'll set that up.
Okay, cool.
Sounds good. All right.
And we'll see you guys next time.
See you.